Hey mamas, so I realized that my daughter is 3 months old today, so I just wanted to make a short little video to kind of update you guys on milestones that she's reached, things that I've been learning in these last several months, and just kind of what a day with a 3 month old looks like. So the first thing that I kind of want to talk about is sleep, because I feel like it is one of the biggest changes for a new mom, because like before having a baby, you just like don't understand the amount of like sleep you won't be getting once your baby arrives. I talked about this in another video that I made talking about just what to expect in the first weeks of being postpartum. So I will link that up here if you would like to check that out. With the sleep, it does get better. I can honestly say that by 3 months, like my daughter has like a way better understanding of like what sleep is and like how to do it. And I know that sounds like kind of crazy, but if you think about it, like they're like learning how to do things, like everything, you know, like they're learning how to do everything right now. And that includes sleep. So they're learning and we are teaching them how sleep works and how to do it. So right now my daughter goes to bed around 6:45 or 7:30 between those times. And she'll sleep until about like between like 5 or 6 a.m., which is like amazing. So I feel like I'm getting like a full night's sleep, and that is because during the day I have her like eating full feedings consistently all throughout the day. So even if she's napping, like I'll wake her up for a feeding and make sure that she's not just snacking, she's getting like a good meal each time she feeds, so that I know that she's getting all of her calories during the day, so that at night I know she can go longer stretches. Another awesome thing that is that in the morning, like when she wakes up around like 5 or 6, like I was saying, like we're able to put her back down and she'll like sleep until like 7:45, which is like a dream. It is a lot of hard work teaching them how to learn how to sleep, but it has been like one of the best things that I've done in these first 3 months. So let me know if you would like a video on how I like sleep trained or just helped teach Callie how to sleep on her own, and just what sleep looks like and what it means. If you'd like to see a video on that, let me know in the comments below and I would love to answer questions or make a video if there's enough of you who would like to hear about that. So let me know. So Callie is also sleeping in her crib. We transitioned her into her crib at about 2 months, I would say, and she sleeps on her tummy, and I know that a lot of people might give me judgment for that, but I've realized talking to like a lot of moms and other parents, like there are so many parents out there who have their babies sleep on their tummies, and I know that there is risk involved, but Callie is like super strong, and so I'm not actually concerned about it. She is like has a really stable like head when she's on her belly. Like she doesn't have a problem turning side to side, and that's usually where the concern is. The concern is that they're gonna put their face in like the mattress, and it's going to suffocate them. But if they're able to like turn their head and they're strong enough to be lifting and turning, then it's usually okay. But of course, talk to your pediatrician. Don't take my word for it, and please, if you are judging me, keep your judgmental statements to yourself. But we did try everything to like have her sleep on her back. We tried the like magic sleep suit. We tried swaddling her. We tried just like, I feel like everything. And as soon as we put her on her tummy, she was like out like a light. So that has really worked for us. So if you are a mom out there also doing that, let me know. I think we are sometimes scared to say that we do that, but I do that. So if there are any of you out there who do that, let me know. So along with sleep, what I've been teaching her is how to do it on her own. So I have been using the Ferber method, which is where you put your baby down when they are really, really drowsy but not completely asleep, and then you leave the room. And so they might cry, and oftentimes they do. I know Callie will cry. I usually set the timer for 10 minutes. And if you're just starting off, you can start it for however, like, much amount of time you are comfortable with. So it can be 1 minute, 2 minutes, 5 minutes, 7 minutes, whatever. You set the time, and you leave the room and you let them cry. And it's really hard. You can put earphones in if you feel like you can't handle the crying, or do dishes, give yourself a job to do so that you're not just like sitting around listening to them cry. But you let them cry for a few minutes, then you go back in if they're not calming down yet, and you soothe them. So you rub their back, you can be like shh, 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 you can just be like, it's okay, it's okay, it's okay. You want to avoid having like conversational like tones with them, so that's why like shh, shh, shh is good, but you don't want to be like, are you okay, what do you want me to do, like, because that's more conversational, if you get what I mean. And then once they are calm, you leave the room again and you set that timer for a little bit longer, and you keep doing that same routine until they learn to fall asleep on their own. And it's hard work, and it like isn't for everyone because you do have to listen to your baby cry sometimes, but it has totally worked for Callie, and honestly she wakes up after a good night's sleep like so happy, and so I know that it's not like hurting her and she's not like super mad at me. So all that to say, right now 3 months sleeping, she is doing a really good job, but it is hard work to get to that point. So all you mamas out there struggling with sleep, I feel you, but there is hope if you're willing to put the hard work in. So right now, some milestones that Callie has reached is she is able to hold her head up really well. So she's super, super strong. Like she'll put her elbows up and she'll just like look around. Like it's none of the bobbing head that like you see when they're like much smaller. But she's like very strong. She has found her hand but hasn't found her thumb, which I am like still waiting for, because I can't wait for her to suck her thumb so she doesn't need her pacifier, which might set me up for more problems in the future, because I know that like sucking your thumb is kind of a hard habit to break, but right now that's what I'm looking for. But she also, I think, has found her feet. She's not grabbing at them, but she'll definitely like focus in on them and like kick, 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 kick as much as she can, which is really fun to see. She is trying to sit up all the time, like whether or not, whether she's laying down and she'll like thrust her elbows into the ground to like try to lift herself up, or if she's like reclining back on us, like she'll like sit up. She's really strong and is like always wanting to be like looking around, sitting up, and like a part of the world. So another thing that she's doing right now is when she's on her belly, she'll roll over to her back, which is really cool to see. So she's done that several times. She loves making saliva bubbles, does that all the time, and she loves looking at like different patterns. And so like she'll like focus in on like the smoothness of like the leather couch, and then like focus in on like the like different textures of my sweater, and you can tell that she's like identifying patterns. And that's typically like three month olds, and even like 2.5 month olds are able to distinguish between like different patterns around them. Another thing, in like these last few months, I've just seen her like wake time increase longer and longer and longer, which is a lot of fun, because like instead of her just like eating and going straight back to nap, she like is up for like an hour or like an hour and a half, and she's like super like alert and wants to play. She loves her little play mat. She loves like listening to songs, and she absolutely loves when I read to her like picture books, and like doing expressive reading. And that's really important because it's like it's helping them with their pre-linguistic skills, and so it's going to just like build their brain to recognize like voice fluctuations, or like words and how they're like words are shorter, longer, things like that. Like everything that we are saying and doing and showing them, they are learning from. And so showing them picture books and reading expressively to them is huge right now during this 3 month, and really even like from like the first day. Another thing that Callie really loves and is also really good for babies in general is being in front of a mirror. So she definitely like recognizes herself. I don't know if she knows that's like, hey, that's me, but she notices like, hey, that's like a person, and she'll like smile at herself, and like we'll put her on the ground and put like a lengthwise mirror, and that's just really good because she's seeing her movements, she's seeing herself, she's like understanding like her movements like have like consequences, you know? So like when she moves her arm will hit the toy. You know what I mean? And so she's like being able to see what she's doing and how it like affects the world around her. So Callie is 3 months old, which means I am 3 months postpartum. And I feel like everything has pretty much gone back to normal with me, but not back to like the way that it was, if that makes sense. So like, I feel like everything's normal, but like my abs, for example, are like so soft. And I notice that like when I eat a big meal, or like not even a big meal, but like eat anything, my stomach like stretches really easily. So before, like, I would have to eat a lot in order to get a food baby, and now I feel like I have a bowl of oatmeal and I'm like 6 months pregnant. So I just feel like my stomach like stretches super easily now. I've been wearing like the leggings that are like nice and high and like tight, because I'm hoping that's gonna like help just like keep my stomach together. And then I've been starting to do a lot of exercises that are going to help with just my ab muscles kind of like reconstructing themselves back together, because like I experienced a little bit of stretching. I don't think they like tore like in half like a lot of women experience, but just stretching. And so I'm kind of like doing exercises now that are going to repair them back together. And lastly, something I've been learning really recently is just focusing on the big picture. So I feel like, you know, the first couple weeks, I really like felt like I needed to do everything right. And I would have like freakouts over like not getting a good nap or not getting a good feeding in. And it would really stress me out. And now I'm just like focusing on the big picture. And so like, I'm like, okay, I want to get a good morning nap and a good afternoon nap. And if like one of the naps in the morning doesn't go well, that's fine. You know, if we have a late night once in a while, like that's fine. Consistency is super important, and babies really thrive off of routine and schedules. But you know, sometimes life isn't going to be routine. Life isn't going to be scheduled perfectly. So teaching them to be a little bit flexible as well is important, and I've been learning that. And so just focusing on the big picture and not getting caught up in like the little things has been really big for me and something I've been learning lately. So I hope this video has kind of given you some insight into what a day with a 3-month-old looks like, and some milestones that maybe you are seeing, or what are milestones you might be looking forward to. If you have a 3-month-old or you have any questions about having a 3-month-old, comment your stories below or your questions below. I would love to hear them. And so would the other mamas in this community. I hope this video has helped you. Again, if you have any questions on like sleep training or how that works, let me know. I would love to answer them as best as I can. I am no expert, but I will try my best. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel, hit that little bell so you don't miss any videos. And I will see you next time. Thanks for listening. Bye guys.